Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Today I'm going to show you how to make your own Maltese bread at home. Since I'm a licensed tour guide in Malta, many times people from my groups have asked me, what is the traditional food in Malta? And my first answer is always Maltese bread. It's crispy, delicious, tasty, and we also use it for many nice recipes, like hops with date, which I'm going to show you later on. Also Maltese ftira, which is a sandwich included in UNESCO World Heritage List, and many, many others. So what you need is some flour, about 450 grams. I use mixed flour, but you can use special flour for bread, or your favorite flour that is suitable for making bread, all-purpose flour as well. So we sift it. Don't miss this part. It's very important to insert air in the flour. Later on, it will help the dough to rise. This one is very fast. Then some sea salt, about teaspoonful. I use some of this. We don't take much salt at home, so it's up to you, but you have to add some. Then yeast, another teaspoonful. I store my dry yeast in this container in the fridge. It can take quite a long time and still good. So one teaspoonful. And optionally you can add some seeds, your favorite seeds, some flower seeds. I'm going to add pumpkin seeds. In the original recipe, it's not included, but this is optional. We whisk it well, and then we add water. It's warm water. In winter, I use a bit hot water, but not very hot, just a bit warm. And we have to form very liquid dough. Not a ball, but very liquid dough, a bit thicker than the one we prepare for cakes. So we whisk it. You can use your hands or your kitchen robot as well. With the kitchen robot, it might take 3-4 minutes. If you add more water than you need, you can add some more flour or keep adding water until it forms it. I don't say we need it because it is with the spoon, but we mix it with the spoon, but still we burn out some calories. Let's see, we remove the stress. In this time I make it every day with this bread, so it well, not. It has to be okay, but you don't form a ball as I said. A bit, not much. Here it is, and I will show you how it has to be liquid. Okay, no need of more. Okay, so this dough, we leave it rise in room temperature. Now here in Malta it's summer and it's very hot. You can leave it outside. In winter I put it in the oven at 330 degrees Celsius, just to warm it up. And it stays there until it doubles the size. We will repeat this 3 times. In 45 minutes, when it's ready, we will whisk it again and leave it again to rise, and we do this 3 times. See you in 45 minutes. The dough doubled its size, and now we have to whisk it again. If you are using your kitchen robot, you have to do it for 3-4 minutes. We will use the spoon again. What you have to do is to whisk it again and mix, stretch it so that we remove the air. It will form a bit more like a ball. Just a bit. Cover it again and leave it again for 45 minutes. I would suggest you to write down the time because you will know how many times you've done it, and you will have the idea when the 45 minutes would pass. See you later. Here I have the dough that has risen 2 times. Now the 3rd time we have to powder it with some flour, and we leave it to rise for the 3rd time. Here you have to use your hands. Put some flour very gently, and we make it. You can see the bubbles, it's forming the bubbles, so it's a good sign. It's very soft, very, very soft. You don't need hard dough. So, we leave it like this for another 45 minutes. Meanwhile, preheat the oven at maximum of 300 degrees Celsius, and put the saucepan inside. It's special for ovens, and warm it up until the dough is ready, and then we bake it. We have left the dough to rise for 3 times, and now it's time to bake it. We just form a nice ball and we put it inside of the saucepan. You have to be very careful because it is very hot, and we put the lid and we bake it for 40 minutes. If you want it crispier, you can keep it a bit longer, but see you when the bread is ready. Once you put the bread in the oven, reduce the temperature to 250 degrees Celsius and leave it to be baked. When it's ready, take it out and keep it on a grid like this to cool down. Or if you don't have a grid, use a wooden board or a plate and just lift it up on one side, maybe like with a knife or something else. Because even if you take it out from the oven, the bread is still being baked. So keep it in mind. Unfortunately, we have to wait some time until we enjoy it. Now my bread is completely cold, and I'm going to show you how to make hops bizet. It's a small sandwich, and we use it throughout the day, even if you pop up in a house and they don't have prepared food for you, and they will serve you this small sandwich. You cut a small piece like this. Look how it is inside. You can see. So you put some conserva on it. This is very thick tomato paste, just a thin layer like this, and you drizzle with some olive oil, because hops bezeit means bread with olive oil. Hops is bread in Maltese, and zeit is olive oil. This was my recipe on Maltese bread. I hope you enjoyed it. Please do try it. It's not that complicated, as you can see, and especially at this time when we don't have much work and we're not that busy, you can spend the morning preparing it, and then you will enjoy it with your family. Thank you for watching my video. I hope to prepare another interesting recipe for you next time. See you.